Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding reflections on the election of our time written by Shiv Vishwanathan. Now the most important thing in this editorial's title is the word reflections and of our time. Now what it means? It means that we need to reflect on the changes taking place in the domain of how elections are fought. Now, in order to understand the changes that are taking place in the domain of election, first of all, we must know about the social reality of India and the two ideological bases of the social reality. Now, there are two ideological bases of the social reality in India. First is socialism. And the second is secularism. These are the two words that have been guiding the entire political scenario and political development in India. So these are the two key words, these are the two key ideologies by which the entire political system is being run in India. Now, if we understand the plain meaning of this word, socialism, it means that the government will be making an effort to provide support to the disadvantaged section. Now, the section that has been left out, section that is not part of the mainstream society. So this is the plain meaning of this word socialism. But when this ideology was used to conduct politics, the meaning of this word was altered. The socialism was used as a shield to promote identity-based politics. Identity-based politics to promote caste-based politics, like Bahujan Samaj Party and Samajwadi Party, they have always been saying that they are trying to promote the interests of the lower caste, and by doing this they are trying to promote what? Socialism. So on the plank of socialism, on the plank of identity politics, on the plank of caste-based politics, these parties, they have grown. But of late, reflections on the election of our time, but recently what we have seen is a stupendous performance by the BJP. 320 plus seats it has got, more than two-thirds of the majority they have in the Legislative Assembly of Uttar Pradesh. So they have given a new meaning to this word socialism. Now as per Shiv Vishwanathan, Modi has led to the demonetization of the political vocabulary. The political vocabulary of socialism and secularism. First of all, let us understand what new meaning has been given to this word socialism by Narendra Modi. Narendra Modi has tried to do away with the politics of caste. He has tried to do away with the politics of identity. Now, how he has tried to do away with it? He has tried to do away with by focusing on the poor, by focusing on the middle class. And this he has done by advertising the idea of demonetization. He has advertised this idea of demonetization in a way whereby he was able to attract the poor classes, whereby he was able to attract the middle classes. The idea of demonetization was projected as it was anti-rich. The idea of demonetization was promoted in a way as if to create a feeling that Narendra Modi's government is pro pro-poor. So this was the reason that this identity-based politics and caste-based politics failed to pick up in Uttar Pradesh in the recent elections. And the new meaning was added to the word of socialism. Now, socialism primarily means that the government be promoting such programs and policies which are pro-poor. Now, the earlier meaning that the government promoting such policies and programs which were pro-particular caste, now this meaning has not gained relevancy. It has lost its relevancy. Now, the new meaning of the word socialism has been highlighted in Uttar Pradesh elections. Now, we have another term. We have another ideology on the basis of which this entire political system was conducted, that is the word secularism. Now, earlier, secularism used to mean that the government will be protecting the minorities and specifically the Muslims. Now, because it was always believed that about 80% of the population in India is that of Hindus, so in order to call itself as a secular nation, it should actually be promoting the rights of the minorities, the Sikhs, the Jains, the Buddhists, and specifically the Muslims. So this was the meaning of secularism. This was the meaning that people believed, that is of this word called secularism. But Narendra Modi has given a message to the society that this is actually not secularism. You are actually biased. You are actually inclined towards the Muslim population. You are actually not promoting secularism. So he has put himself in the neutral stance, and by putting himself in the neutral stance, he has actually not given any seat to the Muslim candidate. He has not fielded any Muslim candidate in the Uttar Pradesh elections. So he has changed the meaning of secularism. Now he has negated this phenomenon of secularism. He has negated this phenomenon of secularism by promoting majoritarianism. Plus, ultra nationalism. So the complete package that was offered by Narendra Modi in this Uttar Pradesh elections, it contains new meaning of secularism, it contains new meaning of word nationalism, it contains new meaning of word secularism. And these new meanings, when added together, they have generated a lot of positive result for the Narendra Modi's government. And it has helped him to garner 2/3 of the majority in Uttar Pradesh Legislative Assembly. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact us at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in joining the offline classes and in buying the online classes and also buying the video class packages. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.